Can this really be a good time to become a Power BI consultant? We're going to look at the long-term picture, but certainly consider the current situation in 2020 as well. Before we start though, the world is certainly facing great adversity at this time, but with great adversity can come great transformation. But that's going to depend on what each one of us decides to do, the action that we decide to take. And hearing from a lot of you, I realize that we're all asking ourselves some bigger questions at this point as we reflect on our lives, reflect on our purpose. We're asking ourselves, how can we be the best versions of ourselves? How can we change our own lives? And how can we help others? Now, for some of you, the answers to those questions may lead to the path of becoming a Power BI consultant. So let's talk about that. So again, we're going to look at the long-term picture. We're going to see how the current situation impacts that and then answer the question, ask ourselves that how can we use that to help others? I'm Avi Singh, Microsoft MVP and best-selling Power BI author. And as a Power BI consultant, I have helped hundreds of companies all over the world. And not just that, I've also helped students all over the world become successful Power BI professionals through my Power BI training programs. Now, if you want to become a Power BI pro, make sure to click subscribe and hit that bell so you are notified whenever I go live to answer your Power BI questions. So let's dive into our video, and we're going to start with the long-term picture. And we're going to break it down in two parts. So Power BI consultant, is that a good idea or bad? Well, we're going to look at Power BI, and then we're going to look at consulting side of things. So let's talk about Power BI. Now, this is the famous Gartner's BI Magic Quadrant. You've probably seen this. Now, this is pretty much the go-to standard to get the lay of the land of all of the BI technologies out there. And this is how things stood back in 2015, and that is when Power BI was officially released. Now you can see the yellow dot there is Microsoft, and you can see it's kind of the middle of the pack, kind of lost in the crowd there. But the rise of Microsoft and Microsoft Power BI is nothing short of amazing as you kind of watch the journey. So this is 2016, 2017, 18, 19, and this is the latest 2020. Microsoft has been since then the clear leader with wide gap between any of the close competitors. So that is good proof of Microsoft Power BI success, but another proof comes from one of their competitors, Google. And I love looking at this, and this comes from Google Trends data, and you can check this out yourself. And this charts the meteoric rise of Power BI and its popularity. So Power BI, by all indications, is certainly a big wave. But here's what I would like you to realize, that this wave is actually riding on much bigger waves. That's what's fueling the growth and success of Power BI in the marketplace right now. So Power BI is riding the big wave of data, the explosion in data, which in turn is riding another big wave, the profusion of technology in our lives, in everything we do. Now, if you do realize that fact, then you also realize that the key to riding a wave is to get in front of it. So if you don't take anything away from this lesson, understand that Power BI, you know, the sooner you step into it, start learning it or start adopting it for your business, the better it is going to be for you. So we have talked about the Power BI side of things. Now let's switch gears and talk about the consulting side of the world. Now this is also another place where the world is changing fast and change is happening, and we got to acknowledge that. And so this comes from the freelancing study in America, and it shows us where the future is headed. And as you can see here, it's saying that the majority of the workers will be freelancers by 2027. That's not that far away. So that's where the world is headed. Now I'm gonna stop you here and make sure to talk about this. So often when people think about consulting and jobs, they think about this in a very black or white fashion. They think that, oh, either I have a full-time job or I'm a consultant. But the reality is actually quite different. In fact, a lot of people are stepping into consulting as a side gig and transitioning gradually as they go along. And as you can see in this graph, a lot of people just, you know, kind of dip their toe into it, get started on it, and then they're doing it monthly, bi-weekly, weekly, and daily. So there's a gradual transition. So stop seeing this as a black and white world, as an either or choice. Most people transition from one to the other. And also, I want to emphasize that this knows no age barrier. So across all age groups, young and old are embracing this and going along with this change. Talking about embracing the change, well, those are actually the two choices in front of you, whether you realize this or not. So as you saw from this data, that the world is headed this way. So either you go with that change and embrace that change and you know, proactively kind of step in that direction, or as unfortunately has happened with quite a few of my old colleagues and ex-colleagues who had been working for many years, sometimes decades in a company before being laid off, and being forced to then accept this change of now then having to explore this world of consulting. All right, so that hopefully gave you kind of the long-term picture from two different vantage points. Now let's move on and talk about the current situation. So hey, clearly, you know, this is, the whole world is being impacted by this and nobody is immune, and businesses all over the world are definitely slowing down, and of course some businesses have been ground to a standstill. So this is a severe impact, but I'll say that we're also seeing a counter trend. And what I feel is that some smart businesses are using this time, this opportunity. And I often say that adopting BI or Power BI is like changing tires on a moving car. It's very hard to do when the business is running that fast. But smart businesses right now are using this opportunity, this slowdown, to focus on their internal systems, their processes, their analytics, their reporting, and automation. So we're seeing a little bit of an uptick there as well. And also, you know, remote consulting is certainly doing well because pretty much that's not an option. That's the only way pretty much the economy and, you know, kind of the workforce is working right now. So those factors are working in favor of consulting, or specifically remote Power BI consulting. Now, how this is going to evolve, well, nobody can kind of tell that, but let's take a look at, so this is the US market and this is a long-term graph. So sometimes when we're caught up in an event, we lose the long-term picture. And here, if you can watch the dips here, you would probably, I certainly remember these events. And so this one was the dot-com bubble burst, and the next dip here was the global financial crisis. Now, as you can see that we did, now these certainly were painful and impacted a lot of lives, but we did pull through. So I would say that the question to ask yourself right now is that, do you believe that we will, as humanity, as a species, as a society, will we overcome this current challenge as dire as it seems right now? And the bigger question is, do you believe that we're going to come out of this stronger than ever? Now, hopefully, if you are looking for some inspiration around this, then I would definitely recommend this video by Simon Sinek about not just playing the long-term game, but the infinite game. So here we have talked about a current situation and how it is going to impact the world of Power BI. But what impact is it going to have on the consulting side of things? Now, this is my opinion. So again, the world was already moving in this direction. There was, and you know, 2027 is not that far away. So we were already moving in this direction. My belief is that the trend is only going to be accelerated, and that is for two reasons. The first reason, that when economies contract and when they start expanding, as is inevitably going to happen, they expand first by looking at consultants. So part-time or full-time consultants, they hire that before they hire full-time employees. And again, the world was, companies were already moving in this direction anyway. And of course, the second big factor is that because a lot of us have been forced to work remotely, I believe that now companies and people are going to be a lot more comfortable working with remote consultants and remote Power BI consultants, and that's going to kind of fuel things in that direction as well. So that's kind of my take on the current situation. But then again, there are bigger questions that we are asking ourselves. And that one is, how do we help ourselves? How do we change our lives? And how do we help others? But before we go there, I wanted to ask you, if you are interested in this topic of Power BI consultant, would you like to see more videos? So here are some of the ideas that I have. Now, I would love it if you can leave a comment and vote for an idea. So these are just labeled A, B, C, D, E. So just write that in the comments. Say, hey, Avi, I would love to see this video. Or if you have ideas of your own, please write that down and I'll come back and create those videos around those topics. So the first topic that I was thinking was that, hey, a lot of people don't even know, like, how do I help a client remotely? How does this remote Power BI consulting thing work? And what does it mean to be an independent Power BI consultant? What is the life like for them? And then maybe, you know, help people try to figure out then how can they answer this question that, hey, is this the right thing for me? What are the factors to consider? Do I have what it takes? Stuff like that. And lastly, well, if I do make that choice, how do I transition from a full-time to, you know, kind of an independent Power BI consultant? And how can I, and I hear this quite a bit, it's like, how can I attract clients without having to sell and, you know, do the hard sell? So again, if you would like to see any of these videos, vote for these ideas by leaving a comment down below. So let's move on to the last part. And I believe this is the most important part. We're asking the bigger questions. And this was a two-parter. One is, how do we kind of help ourselves? How do we change our own life? And how can we help others? Let's talk about the first part first. And this is, again, as I said, about becoming the best version of yourself, living your best life possible. Now, I realize that the answer to this is going to be very subjective, and only you can decide that. But I have been working with a group of professionals for about 2 years now and helping to coach them and you know, grow them into successful Power BI consultants. And I can share with you that the principles that we live by, and those are three. The first one is to make an impact and use our Power BI skills to help others. The next one is to do what we love. And really, because if you do what you love, it isn't work anymore, and you just get to enjoy every day of your life. And lastly, freedom to create a life by our own rules. I really believe, if anything, this current situation has, you know, taught me, is that life is too short to mess around. And if you do want to live your best life possible, at some point you're going to have to go for it. Now, if you are interested in the Six Figures Power BI Consultant Program, then we're going to link it up in the corner and in the details below. You can find out more information about the program and join the waitlist. But let's move on to the other part, which is, how do we help others? Now, this is where I must admit that I was feeling quite helpless, as perhaps a lot of you were as well, where I felt like, I'm not a doctor, I'm not a nurse, and I've heard all those stories, and they're working heroically, saving lives and putting their own lives on the line, but I felt so helpless that I can't do anything, and how can I help others? Now, this is where I you know, came across this idea of a zone of genius. So think about this. Think about, imagine a musician. What would be their job at this time? What would be the best way that they can help others? Well, that's simple. By creating the most beautiful music they have ever created. And that's how they can inspire or comfort others. So think about us. Well, what is our zone of genius? If it is Power BI, your job is to help your company, your clients, create the most beautiful and powerful Power BI models and reports. Help the business, and you would be helping all the people involved and impacted by that business. With great adversity can come great transformation, but as I said, it is going to depend on each of us, and I know that you will make the right choice. Click to watch our next video. Don't forget to subscribe. And until next time, power on, my friends.